And welcome back to Let's Play Heroes of Eternity, The White March, Part 2, Flying. Saw the gate going down? We already opened it. It's weird how I load the game and it's up and it slowly goes down. When we opened it with this lever, all these people came out of these cells and attacked us. They went insane. Well, they were already insane, but then they turned psychotically insane. So, I don't know what's down here, but we had to rest after that, just in case.
No problem.
Something drives them crazy down here. They really didn't want the gate open, apparently.
A dismal place. We may as well be at the bottom of the sea.
Hmm. Oh, hello?
Who's there?
He walked away again, though. Okay. We can't actually look at that. Door is sealed shut. Oh, there's people in there. Oh, are they gonna fight us too if we open that? No tide cipher. What's this? A scroll of revival. Cool. That brings the dead people back to life. Two moonstones. Now, let me just look. The ADS says lore 7. Lore 1. Poor Adair. Lore 0. Huh. Okay, so me or Aelath can use this. Give it to myself. Oh, right. I forgot about that. I don't think we use this thing anymore. Let me just put it here just in case so I don't forget about it. So now I can revive people with that scroll. Pretty cool. Oh. I have more of them. You know what? Wizard's double is good. I don't need iron skin. We might hold on to it though. I don't know. We can give half to him. Oh wait, I wanted to actually give him 2 and give Theodas 2. Cool. Let me just quick save over that. What's in the pot, man? Opal. 1 opal. Alright, should we check in here first? The guy came from there. Never mind who goes there. Oh, a low tide paladin. Alright, they're gonna fight us now. Oh boy, there's a bunch. No, no! I was hoping you don't get through here.
Comes for you.
Oh. Switch our weapons back. Which I'll actually be clever with this fight.
Ah!
Ondra, stay back.
Yeah.
Alright, I like this spell. Spark the souls of the righteous. They will get sparked and yeah. It'll be neat. I'd use her powers, but she'd get interrupted. Yeah. This paladin's already messed up. Which is good news to me. What's this ball? I like this ball. Throw it there. Knock down. Boop. Did he cast it? I guess I couldn't see it over this. Oh, I was clicking him. Well, might as well attack. It's DNS. Hold on, let me just fix my mouse here. Mineha! Oh, that one's almost dead. Well, these guys are free. Alright, knock him down then. You'll run all around. Nice. Is there only one left?
Of course.
Wait a second. Are we getting hurt by our own electricity?
Now this I have.
Oh! I haven't noticed this one back here. I didn't even see her. I'm like, what the hell's with the noise? Who's choking? They have really low grade equipment. Nothing good. I'll take the bloodstone. And the lockpicks, although I'm never going to use that many lockpicks. What's this all about?
Keeping an eye out.
It's about keeping an eye out, that's what it is. Ooh, 3 sapphires. It's an interesting thing, like those tentacles that drag Manea under. Let's see what's in this little room then. Let's go in here.
I can do that.
Yeah. I think we could spare a lockpick. We have 190 of them.
That's settled.
We speak to Farentis? Greetings. He's the guy who walked out and said, "Who goes there?" Tufts of downy gray hair sprout from the back of this man's scalp like shrubs. His lower lip curls inward over a row of teeth that appear to have mostly fallen out, and a musty odor hangs around him like a fog.
Is that you, Edith? I thought I'd lost you. I called for you. I wanted to search, but the blizzard lasted days. I'm so sorry.
Aw. He extends a hand in a gesture of apology, but then the fingers curl and he draws it back. He squints as if trying to see you better. He's going to attack us any moment, is he?
But wait. We did find you. When the thaw finally came, I saw you rigid, frozen. You cannot be Edith.
And you can't be Archie Bunker.
No, we are in the Abbey, gift bearers. And you must be the Tidebringer.
Yeah. Let's lie. Correct. I am the Tidebringer.
Then listen well, Tidebringer. Kauto does not know what he asks.
That's how you say that.
Nor did I when I performed the Tidebringer's duties so long ago.
Kauto, right? I was saying Kyoto.
The Halls of Silence. They take our minds, memory by memory. It would be peaceful, we were told, like going to sleep. Look around you. We, the low tide, who have been sealed down here all these many years, do we seem at peace to you? We are lost, terrified.
Yeah, and insane. Who are you?
No one has asked me in I don't know how long. Who was I? I was the High Abbot, wasn't it? High Abbot. Farentis. That was me. Or the one before me, if not. No longer, though. I am just another brother of the low tide. I remember a woman. Was she my wife?
Edith?
She had curls in her hair, and she spoke softly. What became of her? I carry so many memories that I took from strangers who wanted to be rid of them. I don't know what's mine anymore. And there are so many holes. Every image a blur or a void. Would that I could be free of this place. Free to make new memories. To know who I am.
You did not choose to be here?
Did we? We did. We chose it. When we thought it was our duty. And that it would be peaceful. But the more we forget, the less we understand. Every day, something familiar becomes strange. If I had known, I'd never have accepted my assignment to the Abbey. Nor would many, I suspect.
He made his choice when he was of sound mind. He's not himself anymore. Better to finish the ritual and release him back to the wheel.
Oh. What ritual? Huh? Your order attacked me.
Few of us know friend from foe anymore. I may be the only one left who can still speak for us.
Yeah, that may be. The rest is just fighting.
They are peaceful in their hearts. It is this place. It has confused and agitated them. Please forgive them.
What is it you want from me?
There is a relic, an aspergillum, it was called. What was it?
He thinks for a while with a pained expression, his lips mouthing words.
Well, it doesn't matter. It controls the floodwaters, but also the outer floodgates. Ondra's Witness! That is the name.
Do we want to be opening the floodgates?
It is down here, but I don't recall how to reach it. The High Abbot knows. If you can find out from him, you could set us free. Open the gates. We would leave in peace and finish our lives in dignity.
Are you certain it's wise to release the low tide in this condition?
We are all so old now.
He chuckles.
There is little damage we could do in this state.
I don't know. We had this old fella in Gilded Veil. Looked harmless, couldn't talk, but he'd bite you if you tried to steal his steak when no one was looking.
Once we are free of this place, we will be able to make memories again. The confusion and paranoia will pass.
What is it that the Tidebringer is meant to do?
The Tidebringer comes to replace the High Abbot. The ritual is called... It is called the Rising. Yes. We carry so many memories. Tragic or dangerous some. We live above for a time, devoted to Ondra. Then we come here to forget it all. Wash our souls clean of the memories. When it is done, a Tidebringer is summoned.
Okay. So I see the progression of how things work.
Those above, the High Tide, they become the Low Tide. It means they are brought here to the Halls of Silence.
Still, being an Andra's gift bearer doesn't seem like a good occupation or calling to me.
But not before the old Low Tide are removed, drowned in a flood, and swept away. The Rising.
Huh. Well, apparently there was a flood. Is it supposed to engulf this whole cavern down here? Because it only went so far and then it froze, apparently. Because I saw the skeletons. Kill them. I'll see what I can do. Farentis nods absently.
Use the door behind me. Safer that way.
There's an aspergillum called Ondra's Witness that functions as a key of sorts to a device that controls the flow of water through the lower floor of the abbey. It is possible to flood the Halls of Silence with this, but it may also be possible to open gates that would allow the low-tide Ondrites to escape. Farentis wishes for the low-tide to be set free. He said it requires a particular relic that lies in the Halls of Silence, and suggested the High Abbot would know how to reach it. Outside the abbey, there is a mural that depicts phrases... Yeah, I saw that. That was there before. A curse of cold clay completed. Grieving mother returns. Cool. Grieving Mother traveled from Hangman's Abbey to the Bay of Crowns, investigating the various reports of vampire appearances. In each case, Grieving Mother discovered that the grave sites had elaborate glass, copper, and adruff devices buried around them. The distinctive intricacy of the devices was traced to a Valian dwarf that had been shunned for his unpleasant practices in Salona and Ancens. When captured, the dwarf claimed his intent was not to create vampires, but to restore life. The vampires were created due to the dwarf's inability to solve a fundamental problem with his machinery. The incredible frequency of the dwarf's activity was not due to co-conspirators, but rather his extensive use of drugs that kept him awake and frantic for days on end. Once confronted, the dwarf put up no fight and allowed himself to be taken into custody. When Grieving Mother left him, he was awaiting trial in Telenir. So, we gained 2205 experience, some amount of money, doesn't say, oddly enough. What's this, 46? Security? Oh, that's new. Prestige? I don't remember this being here. Okay, items. Remembrance of Life's Warmth. This curious device, created by a deranged dwarven animancer, has the ability to cast the druid spell Garden of Life. Which I do not know what that does. Friendly AoE. Oh, okay. Plus 20 endurance. And plus 20 endurance. Okay.
Hello.
Farentis smiles. It is unclear whether he recognizes you.
Use the door behind me.
Okay. So we'll leave those guys in there. Probably. Let's sneak.
Oh, and if I find something good, you can have half.
Is this where the water comes from? Another acrid and pungent smell from the depths of the pit. Oh, that's the other door there. Valoon, turquoise, and... apparently six turquoise, yeah. They like their turquoise here. So that's why he said use the door behind me. Beyond the door, you catch glimpses of shapes in the darkness. Wails and whispers, faint and erratic, echo from within the sealed halls. Okay. Ditto. The door appears to be barred from the inside. It does not budge. We might have to fight more of them, because I do want to explore this place. Yep. Just a one? Great. Awesome. Don't need any of that.
Margaret's fire casts light in dark places.
Glimpses of stuff. Door is sealed shut. Okay, so they all live beyond these doors, obviously. Oh, something here. Potion of minor regeneration. I'll leave the other stuff. The rising waterway location. Hmm. Before I mess with this, a turbulent murmur echoes faintly from the depths of this chasm. Is that a door? What's in here? Oh, we're gonna have to fight them. I wanna see what the goodie is over there, that's why. Death to the monk! I might have to keep them with ranged. Can I jump down on them like that?
I'm ready.
Came out. Woo! Okay. Oh, wait. I have to switch. Between red hand prints, a clump of hair dangles from a stain of thick, coagulated blood. Okay, I didn't necessarily want to read that. Oh, she's in here? Okay. Punch. Trying to knock him down. Oh, I did knock him down. Oh my. Well, she's in there. Yeah, just heal her. Is she completely down? She is. Damn. Don't attack us, you idiot. Alright. Robes. Wizard's double. Potion. Bloodstone. Minor regeneration.
Whew, good thing I sold most of my jewelry.
That opens that, yeah. Okay. Okay, should I mess with this thing? Different scenes of an ocean shoreline are carved into four stone panels, arranged almost haphazardly at different heights along a network of rails. Inspect the panels. This might have to do with the thing up above. The end, the flood, the ebb, and the beginning. Inspect the panels. Panels are affixed to a set of rails that curve and crisscross in patterns that remind you of seaweed. There are four depressions in the wall behind the rails in which the panels look like they would fit. The panels show variously a barren shore, a city in flames, a flourishing city, and a tidal wave. Inspect is that. Okay, arrange. It appears that any panel can be slid into any depression by following the network of rails. It's not telling me, though. All I have is written, and through the end is number one. Salmon the flood is number two, so that's the tidal wave. Disamon the ebb is number three, and Diamthu is the beginning. Barren shore. You grab the panel and slide it on the rails into the first available opening. Once the panel matches the recess on the wall, you gently press on it. It slides without resistance and locks into place. Into the first empty depression? Should it be the second one? Or the first empty one is the second depression? Because it's the empty one. Tidal wave? I think the flourishing city should be first. City in flames? I don't remember the city in flames, that's the thing. Huh. You complete the sequence with the last panel, but it will not settle into the final depression. Suddenly, the stone slabs begin to move on their own and revert to their original positions. Alright, flourishing city. Then the tidal wave. It's the flood. Then the city in flames. Mm-hmm. and the barren shore. Nope. Okay. How about the end? Right? That makes sense, actually. It's on fire, tidal wave comes, and then there's a barren shore, and then there's a flourishing city. Right? Kind of makes sense. City in flames, too. And then the flood is a tidal wave. And then the barren shore. And then the flourishing city. I don't see the option to push the button this time. You complete the sequence with the last panel. It slides gently into its recess on the wall. See? I didn't need... what's his name to figure this out? I forget his name. Wahoo or whatever the hell. The remaining panels retract and lock into place. Behind the heavy stones there is a metallic groan and then a steady whir. A small tile about waist high slides back. Beneath there is a carving. It shows an image of an ocean wave curled around a crescent moon. I found a strange set of mechanical panels before a chasm in the Halls of Silence. Despite having arranged them in the proper order, it seems there's something else I need in order to complete the sequence and trigger whatever mechanism it governs. Okay. You stand again before the four stone panels. Yeah, I need whatever thingy. And the water comes from there. A turbulent murmur. Okay. Yeah, I know where that goes. Let's go to the ramparts then. Or actually... the cliffs? That item might be out there. Interesting how we ran into this little side quest just out of nowhere. I'm gonna quick save because I'm not sure if we're falling down a cliff or what.
Margrin's fire casts light in dark places.